morning, dear students. We are learning our lesson tissue from class 9. So we are talking about tissue. So we have talked about meristematic tissue. In that we have seen everything related to the meristematic tissue, three types of meristematic tissue. Now we are going to talk about other plant tissue. There are mainly two types of plant tissues. Those are there are two mainly tissues, that is firstly simple permanent tissue and second is complex permanent tissue. So these are two tissues. You all are knowing meristematic tissue, after its particular growth, it turns into permanent tissue. This changes into permanent tissue. After its particular growth, it changes into permanent tissue. I have already told you, meristematic turns into permanent tissue. So there are two types of permanent tissues, that is simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. So simple permanent tissues are mainly made up of only one type of cells. These simple permanent tissues are mainly made up of only one type of cell, while complex permanent tissues are made up of more than two types of cells. Means different kinds of cells are present. Complex permanent tissues are made up of more than two types of cells. See the main difference between simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. This is made up of only one type of cells. These simple permanent tissues are made up of only one type of cell, while these complex permanent tissues are made up of more than two types of cells. So students, we have seen the definition of tissue. Tissue is a group of similar cells to perform a specific function. But here is a little difference in complex permanent tissue is this is made up of more than two type of cell. But the interesting thing is that it performs a specific function only. It performs specific function. So it is quite interesting that even it is permanent tissue, which is simple permanent and complex. Simple permanent tissue is of one type of cell and performing a specific function, while complex permanent tissue is made up of more than two type of cells, but it performs a specific function. So we will talk about now complex permanent tissue. We will not discuss about simple permanent tissue. Later on we will discuss about simple permanent tissue. So we are talking about complex permanent tissue. Now, this complex permanent tissue, you can see in the name of only complex. Do you feel something? It was simple. It is complex, more than two types of cells. More than two types of cells means what exactly? This is complex, means complicated we can say. The cells are complex means complicated. Who make it complicated? So actually complex permanent tissue is made up of both kind of cells, means though two types of cells are there. Living cells are also there and dead cells are there. So complex permanent tissues are made up of, it's a combination. It is a combination of living cells also and dead cells also. So these living cells and dead cells working together to form a specific function which makes them complex. Okay, and what is the actual function of the complex permanent tissue? What exactly this whole complex permanent tissue does? This complex permanent tissue is conducting water and food and giving a mechanical support. Means if you will be asked what is the specific function for the complex permanent tissue, then the specific function for the complex permanent tissue is it carries It carries food and water. Now where it is carries food and where does it water, where is it carries water, we will see in further class. So it carries food and water, and second, it gives mechanical support to the plant, and all tissues. Okay student, do you get it? See, I said you there are two types of permanent tissue, that are simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissues are made up of only one type of cell, while complex permanent tissues are made up of, these are complex, it has to perform a complex function, so it is complex, and so that it is made up of, or it is combined, or it is composed of living cells also and dead cells also, so that it is said to be complex. Then what specific function is performed by the complex permanent tissue? The specific function performed by the complex permanent tissue, it carries food and water, as well as it gives a mechanical support to the plant and the all tissues of the plant. Okay, it is clear for you. Now I will go ahead. Are there types of the complex permanent tissue? Yes, there are two types of the complex permanent tissue. This complex permanent tissue is of two types. First is xylem and second is phloem. Now, one more interesting thing, the xylem and phloem are specifically conducting tissues. Now we will talk about it, this xylem and phloem. Combinedly known as vascular bundles, or vascular tissue. These are also said to be conducting tissue. Conducting tissue. Do you get? This is complex permanent tissue. These are of two types, xylem and phloem. Together, the function of it is to conduct food and water, and it gives mechanical support. So this xylem and phloem combinedly called as a vascular bundles or tissue or conducting tissue. How these are arranged? See, these are also said to be a plumbing system of a plant. Do you know what plumbing system performs in our home? See, if you will take an example of a huge building, and if the water is stored under the, means the tank is stored in the ground, then what will happen? Water is drawn through the pipe, okay, and that water will be reaches to every apartment of the building. It will reach to every apartment of the building through a small channel, through a thick pipe. It will be reaching to every part of the apartment of the building. In this manner only, the xylem and phloem is together working. The xylem specifically in one direction, that I will let you know. So this xylem and phloem is working as a plumbing system of a plant. Means it is moving. Okay, I will let you know now slowly. So this is vascular bundles are called as a, xylem and phloem is called as a vascular bundles, and xylem and phloem are also said to be a conducting tissue. So there are two types of tissue. Now we will see specifically every tissue. All tissues we will see, so xylem and phloem we will see. So in complex permanent tissue, we will talk about first xylem. Xylem is vascular bundle, conducting tissue. So xylem properly. See, this xylem word is actually come from the word xylon. Xylon or xylos. This xylem word comes from the Greek word. This xylem word has come from the Greek word, and that Greek word was xylon or xylos. What does it mean? It means wood. It is wood. Means it is thick pipe-like structure. This xylem is just thick pipe-like structure, and which is only making it to conduct water. Okay, so xylem are mainly वॉटर कंडक्टिंग टिश्यू. एज आय सेड यू कॉम्प्लेक्स परमनंट टिश्यू मध्ये काय असतं तर दीज आर ऍक्च्युली फूड अँड वॉटर कंडक्टिंग टिश्यू, बट दिस झायलेम इज वॉटर कंडक्टिंग टिश्यू. ओके, अँड दिस झायलेम वर्ड कम फ्रॉम द झायलॉन ऑर झायलॉस विच मीन्स वूड, मीन्स दीज आर थिक ट्यूब लाईक वॉल, थिक ट्यूब लाईक स्ट्रक्चर इज प्रेझेंट. ओके, सो दॅट झायलेम इज सेड टू बी वूडी, मीन्स इट इज थिक. ओके, सो दिस इज झायलेम विच वर्ड कम फ्रॉम द ग्रीक वर्ड दॅट इज झायलॉन. And this is called as a conducting tissue. So this is performed like a plumbing system. What plumbing system does? Plumbing is means carrying a water from the source and reaching to each and every part of the building. If we will take the example of a building of a small house, it is reaching wherever it is required, that water is reaching. So here also in the plant, water is drawn from the root system and reaching to every part of the plant body. But here one interesting thing is that the flow, suppose see, if this is a tree and this tube like structure is present, just now I said you thick tube like system is present, or this is said to be conducting tube also. So water has taken from the root, this water is taken from the root and that water is carried in this direction and reaching to every part of the plant. Okay, every part of the shoot system that water is reaching. Okay, and so that the flow of the water from the root is unidirectional. It's very important thing, the flow of water is unidirectional, means this water is flowing from the root to the plant only in one direction. The water never comes down from the top to the down, the water never comes. You might have seen some people are giving, whenever they are watering the plants, they are pouring water to the shoot system. This is actually wrong. This is wastage of water too, because see, the plant can become fresh because the dust particles would move, some soil particles which are accumulated on it can be removed out through the water. Means plant can only be fresh by pouring water on a shoot system, but actually it is wrong. It is wastage of water because the leaves or the shoot system never absorbs water like root. And so that there are two systems are present in our irrigation system, that are drip and sprinkler irrigation, because root are only performing the function to absorb water from the ground, not the leaves. So this is actually the wastage of water to sprinkle water on the whole plant. It is not necessary. Only plant can become fresh, means dust particle and soil particles can go away, except if there is no function of the water pouring on the its shoot system. So the flow of water only in a one direction. Okay students, do you get it? What is function performed by the xylem? Xylem word come from the Greek word that is xylon. Xylon means wood, means this actually this xylem tissues are actually thick and stuff covering, through that the water is going in a only one direction. So the flow of water in a xylem tissue is unidirectional. Okay students, do you get it? Now we will go ahead for the component of this xylem tissue. This xylem tissue is actually has four components. Xylem is composed of four components. What are those? We will see one by one. See, first component is tracheids. Second component is vessels. Third component is xylem parenchyma. You are not still acquainted with the word parenchyma, chlorenchyma, sclerenchyma. Very soon you will be acquainted. Just now you are acquainted, but very soon you will come to know exactly what is the meaning of it, because I am going to teach you simple permanent tissue, in that it will be more clearer for you the word parenchyma. Okay, and after it xylem Clearing chyma. Little bit different pronunciation, but pronounce like this only, parenchyma and sclerenchyma. So one by one, we will see the function of every component of xylem. Xylem tissue is composed of four kind of components of it. First is tracheids. These are vessels. This is xylem parenchyma and xylem sclerenchyma. So how is the function of tracheids exactly? We will see. These tracheids are exactly designed like this. You can see. These are tracheids. Before going ahead, I would like to know, these tracheids and vessels are actually the conducting path. Means what is the function of this? Very soon I will let you know. But exactly what is conducting water into the xylem tissue, that is tracheids and vessels. So these are the main part to conduct water from the root to every part of the plant. So tracheids and vessels are playing important role here. So these are very important. You should know the structure of it. These are the supportive tissues for the xylem. So these are tracheids and these are designed like this. You can see this end. These ends are not open like this. These ends are not open. So these tracheids are not designed one above other. Okay? Because these are not open. These are not conducting water into this direction. Do you get, students? These are not conducting water in this direction. These are arranged side by sides. These are arranged side by side. And these ends are called as a tapering end. Tapering ends. Means tracheids have tapering ends. And these are, see, the first function or first structure of it is tracheids have tapering ends. Means just like this, tapering ends is present. And these are tube like. The second is, these are tube like. Okay? Tubular or tube like structure, we can say. The third is, it has a small pores on it. Why these pores are designed? If it is closed, this whole tube is closed, then where the water would go? How water would pass from this first tracheid to the next tracheid to the third tracheid? How it will pass? So here are small pores on its body, and through that water will pass from first tracheid to the next tracheid to the third tracheid. In this manner the water would pass. Do you get, students? So tracheid is designed like this. It has a tapering end, so it cannot stand one above other. It cannot stand like that, because this is a tapering end and this is closed, so that water cannot pass vertically here. Did you get it? Water will pass horizontally here, because it has a small pit like. Small pits are present on the wall of a tracheid, and so that horizontally the water can flow. Okay, so this is the structure of tracheids, and this, it has a tapering ends. This is tube like, and it has a small ends, and through that water can pass horizontally. Okay, so tracheids, do you get? This is actually the main conducting path into the xylem tissue. So this is related to the tracheids. Now I would like to know you about vessels. This vessel, how the vessels is designed? The vessel is designed like this. Its upper and lower end is open, and so that this can be designed one above other. Do you get it? So the water can flow easily like this. Okay? This is the beginning and this is the end of the other. So water can flow from down to the up through this vessels. Means tracheids are moving water horizontally, while vessels are moving water vertically. Do you get, students? These are also tube-like. These are also tube-like structure. Okay, one point I forget to tell you, that as I said you, these are complex permanent tissue, and these are made up, it is the combination of living cells and the dead cells. So very important thing, sorry to let you know, let these trachets and vessels, their walls are tough. Their walls in the trachets are, so their walls are tough, and these walls are said to be lignified wall. These are lignified walls, means these are dead cells. These trachets and vessels are dead cells. These are not living cells. Okay, dead cells. This is made up from dead cells, and so that lignified walls means there is one substance, lignin, which make them dead and which make them very very tough. So lignified means these are tough, very tough, hard, and so that it can pass water also. If it will be smooth, then water can spread everywhere. So that what happens, specifically it is moving to every part of the plant because of the presence of lignin. So the wall into the trachets and into the vessel is lignified wall. Dead cells are present because of the presence of lignin. So this is tube-like structure, and the ends of it, is open. The end is open, and so that water can flow vertically from down to the up. So these actually trachets and vessels are performing a specific function to conduct the water. So we have seen the structure of vessels also. Now we'll go ahead for the xylem parenchyma. Now what xylem parenchyma actually performing a function? This xylem parenchyma is actually stores food. It stores food, and very interesting thing to know that this is living cell. These trachets and vessels are dead cells, but this is living cells are present into the xylem parenchyma. Actually, trachets and vessels are conducting water. These are just supporting, the stores food into the xylem parenchyma, and this is living cell. Okay, this is only the function for the xylem parenchyma. These are the main two parts. Now, what is the function of the xylem sclerenchyma? Now, again, xylem sclerenchyma are again dead cells. Means, suppose if we will take this. I am drawing the structure of coconut shell. Then coconut shell, you can see the wall of the coconut shell. The wall of the coconut shell are very very tough because these are also lignified. Lignified walls means lignin is present, which make the coconut shell very very tough. So these are dead cells only. These are also dead cells. Then what exactly happens whenever the coconut falls from the, because you are knowing coconut tree is very very tall, and when the fruit is falling, coconut falls from the very from the height. When it falls on the ground, it does not break. Why it does not break? Because of this lignified wall. It is making the fruit cemented, means fruit is very very tough, and because of it is one kind of protection given by the nature to the coconut. So the wall is lignified because dead cells are present, and what is the function performed by this is it gives a mechanical support to the plant, means it is protecting the plant. So here also this xylem sclerenchyma are dead cells, and this is performing a function of giving support, means it gives, these are dead cells, and it gives mechanical support to the plant tissue and whole plant. Okay student, do you get? I would like to conclude now the topic, that is xylem. So we have gone from first plant tissue. Various types of plant tissues are there: protective tissues, protective tissues, meristematic tissues, and permanent tissues. So protective tissue already we have talked about, meristematic tissue also we have already talked about. Then after it I have gone with the permanent tissue. So permanent tissues are, means meristematic tissue, whenever it completes its growth, it turns into permanent tissue. And this permanent tissue are actually made up of two types of tissues, that is simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissue is made up of only one type of cell, while complex permanent tissue is complex because of the combination of dead cells and living cells. And complex permanent tissue is included xylem and phloem, and xylem and phloem is said to be a conducting tissue, or we can say this is said to be a vascular bundle too. So then specifically we have seen the function of xylem. What xylem is actually performing a role? Xylem is conducting water from the root to all the parts of the plant body, and so that xylem tissues are also called as a plumbing system of the plant tissue in the plant system. Okay, so this is said to be a plumbing system, and there are four components of the xylem tissue, that is tracheids, vessel, xylem parenchyma, and xylem sclerenchyma. Sideways conduction of water is carried through the tracheids. Then vertical conduction of water is carried through vessels. So tracheids and vessels are playing an important role in conducting water into the plant, and xylem parenchyma stores food, and it is living cell into the xylem tissues, while sclerenchyma is dead cells and which gives the mechanical support to the plant. Thank you.